gonna bounce back from business to the streets and sports. Sports, drugs, and entertainment. All right, that's the culture. Or I'm taking the music. So this brokership class, right? Everybody say crumb snatchers.
Crumb snatchers.
Team crumb snatchers are the employees. These are the rappers. These are the ball players. I'm not saying you can't be a rich crumb snatcher. You could be a crumb snatcher and drive Lamborghinis, big chains, pretty women, and be a crumb snatcher. You are the rapper, you're the ball player, you're the employee. You could do well, but guess what? You own nothing. Everybody say own nothing.
Own nothing.
Everybody say own nothing.
Own nothing.
They control nothing.
Control nothing.
Okay, this is our crumb snatcher, our broker class, our employee class. Y'all leveled up. The next level after broker and employee and crumb snatcher, you know what it is? Everybody say ownership.
Ownership.
Everybody say ownership.
Ownership. Ownership.
The ownership class means y'all are the basketball team owners. You own the football team. You own the t-shirt company. You own the record label. You own your block. You are the biggest drug dealer on your neighborhood. You better not be. Ownership means what an owner has, everybody say a right.
A right.
Entitled.
Entitled.
See, brokers make money by doing things for other people. Shooting hoops for other people. Thumbing the ball for other people. Rapping on the mic, doing concerts for other people, selling drugs, pitching for other people. The crumb snatchers. Hey guys. The owners are in control or have ownership and have a right and title over the brokers. Am I making this make sense a little bit?
Yeah.
You guys own a record label.
You gotta answer the
offer. Right? But then, right, you guys are the football team owners. You own, what's your favorite football team? Or basketball? You don't got one? Or are you on the Lakers? What's yours? You own the Cowboys? What's yours? You own the Kansas City Chiefs? Yours. You own the Ravens? Yours. You own the Saints, right? Okay, so y'all own a team. But now, this little trick that nobody talked about. Outside the owners and the controllers, there's these quiet people in the background. You got the brokers and the owners. Look at these quiet people in the background. Everybody say controllers.
Controllers.
That control everything. The definition of control is to have the power. Everybody say the power.
The power.
Everybody say the power.
The power.
To influence.
To influence.
Outcomes.
Outcomes.
The controllers have the power to influence the outcomes. So, although you got basketball and football team owners right there, they control the players right there. You are the commissioner of the league, commissioner of the NBA, commissioner of the NBA, NFL. You're the shareholder of the record company,
majority.
The majority shareholder. You are the plug, okay? Yeah, he owns the block. They pitch it for him on the corner, but you're the plug in Mexico. You are the commissioner of the league, or you are
baseball. Major League Baseball.
Major League Baseball, yeah. Fine. Or the chairman of the bank. So while you're the chairman of the bank, he may own a whole multi-family real estate complex. He owns 200 units of real estate as an owner. This was his real estate agent, his broker. The agent got 3% commission on a $7 million property, $140,000 commission. Feels good. Feeds his family as a crumb snatcher.
You got to get the crumb snatcher.
You own the real estate. estate. You got 200 rental units bringing cash flow to your family, plus appreciation, tax advantages, cost segregation, capital appreciation, and all that. Lit.
There you go.
But he's the bank who signed your note and your mortgage to foreclose on you should you not pay. He has the control. What we have to learn more as a community is to understand the difference. It's not about what you drive. It's not about your chain. It's not about your bling. It's not about none of that surface level stuff. It's about power.
Come on.
It's about the ability to influence outcomes. One more time, down here.
The ability to influence outcomes, family.
You are the leading activist in the black community. You done shut shit down and discriminated against us. You done ran out and protested the police station. You done rioted and burnt some police cars. You done led a march with black men with a bunch of guns. You are a political broker for Republican Party and Democratic Party saying what they should or shouldn't do for us. You believe in reparations. You're waiting for reparations. Hoping folks get it to us. Let's tweet. Let's hashtag. Let's blog. Let's start a YouTube channel about reparations. Crumb snatchers. Y'all level up and y'all come together. Get a circle around me. Y'all come together and say, you know what? We're going to start the first black political party. We're going to own our own politics. But guess what? We're going to own black politics, have our own black political party. Not the Democrats, not the Republicans. We're going to be the black unions. We're going to have our own party, right? So we got ownership now. We got a right and a title. But guess what? We got a political party in their system.
How can you win?
You're an activist, you think you lit. You get a political party, you got ownership, so we ain't even did yet. But you still have no what?
Power.
Still have no what?
Power. Man, family, that's
power
deep.
Power is the ability to do what?
Control outcomes.
Say influence.
Influence.
Outcomes. So we fight in a system politically to have some kind of political say-so as activists. Haven't even leveled up enough to have our own political party, but even if we did so, we don't have our own governing system. Own nationality, our own power. So what I'm telling you this in BDA, we're gonna sit down in a second, and I'm gonna talk about a quick quiz I wanna do on entrepreneurship. But what I want you guys to understand as you go through life, you can do surface level and be a crumb snatcher and still have a rolling. You can still have the gains and be a crumb snatcher. You can be an owner and have a right or a title and be lit. But the ultimate outcome is to have power. It's controller shit. I call it plug shit. Connect shit. That's the ultimate outcome as a king. And what we're doing here is we're building what? We're building what?
Kings.
Kings build what?
Kings.
Kings build what?
Kings.
Kings build kings. So we all can have dominion, control, and power to influence outcomes of our kingdoms. The first kingdom you need dominion, control, and power of is your damn self. You need power over yourself when your friends don't influence you to make decisions. You know why? Because you got power. You influence your own outcomes. Nobody influences your outcomes. So your first level of power is being able to influence your own outcomes. Not somebody else to broker the idea for you or own your outcome for you to do, not your mom or your daddy. To influence your own outcome. That's power. That's the first, is yourself. The second level of power is to do it for your family as the family CEO. The leader and visionary of your family. And the third level of power is to do it for your community. Once you do it for self, once you get your family straight, you have a responsibility to do it for your race and your community. in that order. So that's where kings build kingdoms, your personal kingdom, your last name family kingdom, and then your race and community ethnicity kingdom. Not as a broker, not as an owner, but as a power player. Does that make sense?
Yes, sir.
Everybody put a fist in the air. Oh, everybody say king power on three. One, two, three.
King power.
Down your neck. King power on three. One, two, three.
King power.
What is power? The ability to do what?
Influence outcomes.
Do what?
Influence outcomes.
Do what?
Influence outcomes.
All right, clap for yourselves and have a seat.
Hold on, hold on.